This is a video presentation on the 10 steps of cleaning. If followed correctly, it will provide you with the ability and knowledge on how to hand over a clean plant every time. So sit back and we hope you find it informative. Step 1. Upon arrival at work, you will be issued with your PPE, your personal protective equipment. This consists of nozzles, lockouts, bump hat, wet weather gear, hoses, gloves, gum boots, and cotton gloves. You will then be issued with your chemicals, which have been decanted into 5-litre containers. Also issued with a bucket, scourer, and any other cleaning utensils needed. After donning your personal protective equipment, you will then attend a team briefing. This will be held by the site manager. He may discuss the previous day's cleaning or any other issues that is required. Your site manager will also discuss with you important dates such as the next OH&S meeting, chemical retraining, and any other important issues such as additional work days that will be required. After attending the daily briefing, you will then commence work in your specified area. Once in your area, start to unravel your hose and check any machinery that may need to be locked out before the commencement of cleaning. Then visually check the machine to make sure there is no damage that has been done by production or maintenance that needs to be reported to your site manager. Step 2. Rough rinse with low pressure. When turning on your main station, ensure that you turn on the water before you turn on the power to the pump. After connecting your hose, turn on the water and ensure that your satellite is on the rinse position. Before you start rough rinsing, check over your machinery to remove any heavy or loose soils that can be done by hand. This will make your job rough rinsing a lot easier and more time efficient. Prepare to clean your machine as per the work instruction. This may include opening any access panels or start to strip machinery. Select the correct nozzle for rinsing, then turn open the tap and wait for the pressure to build up in the pump. Once the pressure is built up enough, start rinsing the machine from the top to the bottom. A rough rinse should be a detailed rinse. You should remove 90% of the soils during this. You also break down a buildup of fat and protein, which will make subsequent steps a lot easier. Step 3. Remove loose soils from floors by using water and squeegees. Do not wash food portions into drains. Place portions into designated containers as per the client's SOPs. Step 4. Foaming the equipment. Remove your rinsing nozzle and insert your foaming nozzle. Ensure that the foaming nozzle is inserted correctly and tightly. Preparing to foam, place the suction hose into the 5-litre chemical container and ensure the satellite is turned from rinse to foam. Also make sure that the air is turned on. Ensure that you have the correct PPE equipment on for foaming, i.e. your glasses, rubber gloves and aprons. Open the valve and move towards the area that requires foaming. Once starting to foam, start from the top of the machine to the bottom. Think of the machine as three-dimensional, trying to get under all lips and hidden areas. Step 5, hand scrub as required. During this step you will need your bucket with diluted chemical and scouring pads. Scrubbing the machine will remove buildups of protein and heavy soils. The machine should be scrubbed from top to bottom, including framework and low-lying areas. This is a very important step. Step 6, final rinse. Remove your foaming nozzle and insert your rinsing nozzle. Take out the suction pipe and turn the machine from foam back to rinse. Give the machine a detailed rinse from top to bottom. Step 7, personal control. After the final rinse, the hygiene operative needs to do a personal control check. Keep the low pressure hose and scouring pad handy. Inspect all areas where cleaned. Give special attention to conveyor rollers and pulleys, conveyor tables, under conveyors, cutting machine blades, and under all frameworks. Defects must be rectified. Once the personal control check is complete, call your supervisor or site manager for a quality control check. Step 8, quality control. The supervisor must do a quality control check after each clean, prior to sanitization. The hygiene operative must be present to rectify any mistakes. A visual tick sheet needs to be completed prior to the area being sanitized. All defects must be rectified prior to sanitization. Step 9, sanitizing. Place sanitizing nozzle, the yellow nozzle, into the low pressure valve at the end of the hose, ensuring that it is inserted correctly. Replace all guards, covers, and loose parts of the machine. Prepare the low pressure system and move the satellite's control to sanitize mode. Place the suction hose into the 5-liter chemical container. Move to the area that needs sanitizing and open the low pressure valve. Sanitizing needs to be done at least 15 minutes before production starts or micro sampling is done. Start sanitizing equipment, walls, floors as soon as the sanitizer starts coming out. Sanitize properly and make sure all the areas and corners are covered as well as loose parts. Step 10, rigging off. Disconnect your hose and roll it up neatly. You must remember to rinse, clean water through both your sanitizing and foaming blocks. This will prevent corrosion and blockages. The correct procedure in turning off your pump is turn off the power at the pump, the main power, and the water. Upon leaving your area, ensure that you have taken all your cleaning equipment with you, such as your hoses, chemicals, and any other equipment that is needed. Do not leave any of your cleaning equipment in the production area. Make sure you place all your hoses and protective equipment back in the appropriate areas. Hand back all nozzles and equipment to the site manager. He will then check in all the appropriate equipment. At the end of your shift, sign off. Say see you later, and we'll see you tomorrow.